German Boy Scouts
video training series. Today, we want to talk about your ability to wear armbands in the United States schools.
This is John Tinker. In December of 1969, John Tinker was one of three students in Des Moines, Iowa, who chose to wear black armbands to protest the Vietnam War. He had two companions in his protest, his sister, Mary Beth Tinker, and a friend, Christopher Eckhart. The local school board had already passed a resolution banning the wearing of such armbands to school. John Tinker and his companions were confronted by school administrators and were suspended until after New Year's Day 1970, that is, the entire length of their planned protest. Tinker's father filed suit on his behalf, citing both the First Amendment of the Constitution and Section 1 of the 14th Amendment of the Constitution. Their argument was essentially this: all American citizens have a right to free speech under the First Amendment to the United States Constitution, and this right, under the 14th Amendment, cannot be abridged without due process of law. The plaintiff's case was dismissed by the district court, which cited the precedent established in Burnside v. Byers. Burnside had established school systems' right to prohibit certain types of free speech. There was a threshold established. The case was taken to the Eighth Circuit Court of Appeals, where the district court's decision was affirmed. The plaintiffs appealed their case to the United States Supreme Court. The legal issue in question was if a prohibition of wearing armbands in public school in protest actually violates the First Amendment.
Oh, hi again. Welcome back to our video series. Now that you know the backstory of the case, it's time to learn about the Supreme Court's decision.
The Supreme Court ruled in favor of Tinker and upheld his right to protest in a public school by wearing an armband. Schools could not prohibit the armband wearing because the protest it entailed was orderly, did not infringe upon the rights of others, and did not significantly disrupt the learning environment. And, therefore, the banning of the armbands was unconstitutional under both the First and 14th Amendments. Of course, the judge's reasoning was much more complicated. That reasoning is as follows.
I'm not going to do that.
One of the critical issues in the case was the Burnside threshold. The actual threshold was this. Expression must materially and substantially interfere with the requirements of appropriate discipline in the operation of a school, end quote, before it can be restricted. Here, stop that. One of the critical issues in the case was the Burnside threshold. The actual threshold was this. Expression must materially and substantially interfere with the requirements of appropriate discipline in the operation of a school, end quote, before it can be restricted. Here, stop that. It was clear that the required interference did not occur. Moreover, they banned the armbands simply to prevent the potential disruption that they might cause. But it has been the consistent opinion of American courts that a fear of future disruption or future transgressions is not sufficient cause to ban or take legal action against anything, much less a First Amendment right. Therefore, banning the armbands was clearly unconstitutional under the First and 14th Amendments of the United States Constitution.
So sexy.
Alright. It's not all gonna be in one shot. Don't worry.
What's your name?